I'm here with Jimmy Montoya, the legendary trainer, Elvis Grant Boxing in the house. So first of all, Elvis, what can you tell us about Jimmy?
He's a legend. I mean, I met Jimmy when I was like 12 years old, and you know, he kind of took me under his wing and taught me how to be a trainer and taught me how to be a man, more importantly. So we've been together a very, very long time.
Jimmy, who are some of the fighters you worked with, for those who are watching?
Grant Phillips.
Okay, how was he? Talented?
Well, hey, no, seriously, this guy helped me out when Keith Mason became my world champion. Grant was there to box with him, you know.
You were sparring him?
And, yeah, and that's awesome. And I'll never forget, he says, he came to me, he had a little blood in his nose, and says, hey, you said five rounds. I said, you can go one more, don't give me no crap. And he did, and he was, you know, he was a good little fighter himself.
Who else? Some of the...
Well, I had Arguello, I had, you know, Richie Sandoval, Macho Camacho, I had Kate Mesa, I had just a bunch of, you know, different guys.
Alexis Arguello, one of the greatest ever. What was it like working with them?
Arguello, let me tell you something. Arguello very much believed that if he didn't eat steak, he would have cramp in his legs and he couldn't function as well.
How did he make weight, though?
No, he did it very easy. But, you know, Arguello didn't have any fat on him. Arguello was a solid fighter. He took care of himself very well, but he liked me. And I remember one day we cooked, and he says, leave it here for the other guys. Hey, you and I are going to go out to Angus and eat a steak. I said, Arguello already cooked. I don't care. I got cramps in my legs. We came out of there, and he came out, you know, going and bouncing and moving around. He goes, man, I feel great.
Look, there's a legend behind you.
Oh. Well,
how you doing, Jimmy? Good morning, good night. Man, how awesome was it to be on stage with all the legends? Tyson.
It's great. I feel it's great.
I know you wear the shirt of Mike Tyson, now you're hanging out with him.
No, why not, man? You know, he's a great person.
And Chavez Sr. was there. Did you study a lot of Chavez Sr. tapes? Because you throw like him
sometimes,
to the body.
Yeah, sometimes, yeah.
Yeah, I know, you gotta run. Thanks, okay, Gennady.
This guy, the amateur.
Hey, one of the best in the world right there.
That's it. He is pound for pound right now.
I told him. He's very humble. He says not yet.
He's a good kid, yeah.
Great
punches,
fighter.
Punches very good. He punches like Michael Kessler. He punches hard.
He punches. He touches you, you go down.
Yeah.
So, Alexis Arguello, how would he compete today against a Mayweather and a Pacquiao?
You know what? Let me put it this way. If Arguello was at his prime, I think he'd beat any of them. And maybe not, because, you know, there's a lot of tricks to the game. But when he was in his prime, he was untouchable.
Let me ask Elvis. Elvis, how do you think Alexis would do these days if he was active?
I mean, Alexis was a great champion. Alexis was a great champion. And as Jimmy said, I think in his prime that he had a good shot with everybody. With all respect, I don't think he would ever beat Floyd Mayweather because he was a plotter and he had trouble with movers. And obviously, we know how good a mover Floyd is, especially when he's using his legs.
But if he fought Pacquiao?
Yeah, I mean, you know, Alexis is the kind of guy who could blast you out with one shot. I mean, he was a textbook fighter. Textbook jab, textbook straight right hand, great liver shot. I mean, he had it all. But I don't know. You know, we'll never know. That's why we have to just dream about it, as we'll never really know.
So my last question, Jimmy, any advice for young fighters? What does it take to be a champion?
Well, my advice is to work hard, stay away from the dope, stay away from the women, and if you're going to love the sport, you better stick to it.
Okay.
You better do the right thing.
You said stay away from two things. What if you can only stay on one? What should I stay away more from, the dope or the women?
Well, I'll tell you what, I'd rather have the women than the dope.
I agree. I like the way you think.
I'll second that motion.
There you have it. Jimmy Montoya. It's okay. For EsNews.com and Malaysia Back Reporting.